afternoon, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nick Kick, and Frozen 2, no time to die fan 2001, and welcome to Nanetto the Hobbit video, where we hope you enjoy my rant on the mystery movie I watched, which honestly, I forgot what the title is, but honestly, I just don't give a crap. Anything, guys, so today I watched The Hobbit 2, and I agree with Frozen and Mitchell, but this has got to be one of the best Hobbit movie I ever seen. So we'll see, the third movie would be my new favorite Hobbit movie than the first movie. So yeah. So today, doing a movie review on The Hobbit of the Destination of the Small. Came out a year of 2013, the same year of Overrated Frozen and Overrated You Are Next, and one of the best movie of 2013, this has to be Man of Steel. Anyway, guys, let's get my thought on this movie, shall we? And really hope you enjoy my review on The Hobbit of Unexpected Journey, because my thought on the first movie is good, but out of that, one of the weakest out of the Earth Saga. So, and I was saying in that review, and I was like, you know what, we'll see this sequel redeem themselves to the first movie. So yeah, I watched this movie earlier, and this movie is not a 10 out of 10, but this movie is a 9 out of 10 for me. So I still have some one negative. It has to be the rake scene. Honestly, that action is so childish and so stupid, and it'll make me want to laugh my butt off. So I was not entertained with that action at all, because that action looked absolutely god-awful. It looked so god-awful, it's not even funny. So I really did not like the rake scene or the action with all the characters and the main character. Have the shaky cam and the water flashing the camera, man, that is way too much. So that's the only thing I really did not like, that scene from this movie. So let's get my thought on this positive of this movie, because I just got done with my one negative. So let's get the story. The story is pretty awesome. I really enjoyed the story way better than the first movie. And the character, like Gandalf, he's a really likable character. And the main character, once again, he's a really likable character. And my favorite character of the entire movie, it's had to be She-Elf, because she played by the same actress she was in Ant-Man and the Wasp. Honestly, I love that movie, but I really do like She-Elf, because she's a really beautiful elf female in the Hobbit franchise. So yeah. Any action of this movie? Didn't get me wrong, because I really enjoyed the action, but I really did not like the action for the wake. So that's only one negative I have for this movie. It has to be the wake scene. Honestly, that scene is so childish and so stupid. But the rest of the action is really entertaining. I really enjoyed the action, and the dragon who played by Doctor Strange. Honestly, he's a really great character. I really like the dragon. Dragon is a fantastic villain. Cannot wait for his final appearance in the third movie. So I'm really curious what the third movie would be like, because in the ending, and when the main character say, "What have we done?" And I was like, "Oh man, we're getting ready for third movie. Woo!" And I have nothing to say about this movie, because I just don't want to give away too many spoilers. So overall, guys, The Hobbit of a Destination of the Small is added up one of the best Hobbit movies I ever seen in my life. It'll even have the wake scene, the so childish. But overall, I think this movie is a really great movie. And this is honestly one of my favorite December movie of 2013. I'm very sorry, Walking with the Dinosaur, you're a piece of crap. But this movie is honestly one of the best December movie of 2013. This movie is a perfect holiday season. A holiday movie you can watch for for the whole family. And I know this movie got some feel action, but still, the Lord of the Rings trilogy is added up one of the best trilogy of Warner Brothers. So we'll see. Dune will be like a level of the Lord of the Rings. So it's getting ready to part two. So hey guys, I am giving The Hobbit 2 a 9 out of 10. I love it, and this movie deserves a feel of Nick Kick awesomeness. Good job, movie. Great job. You redeemed yourself to the first movie. Well, even I enjoyed the first movie, but it is honestly one of the weakest out of the Earth Saga. So I at least forgot this movie. So we'll see the Hobbits or the Battle of the Fire Army will be the best epic conclusion to the Lord of the Rings, just like the Return of the King. So again, that was my movie review on The Hobbit of a Destination of a Small. Tell me what's not this movie in the comments section below, where I spoiler. And probably after this, after I get done brushing my teeth, eat my lunch, I'm gonna rewatch Bikosa because I keep getting that that ant can't in my head because she's pretty attractive for a mother character, for the ant character in Disney movies. So at least it's way better than watching crappy anime movies. So I'm not gonna explain about that. So hey guys, I am canceling my Cruise the Movie rant because I am not taking this movie right. I am not taking that movie right to Susie. So I might do that in my Letterboxd. So stay tuned for that. And stay tuned for my water video in the future. I really hope I can do my act Nick Cakes 2001, but I just don't want to copy Rambo and Shrekback, Freeman, and etc. So hey guys, if you liked this Hobbit video, please hit the subscribe button, turn notifications, show this family. So stay tuned for my tomorrow review on the Hobbit, the Battle of the Fire Army. It's gonna be the best Hobbit movie I ever watched. Woo! I'm excited. And so you gotta see you next time. So long, peace of two, you shall not pass.